Vaterland.
Good morning, everybody. Yeah, I'm waiting just for 2 minutes for the others to join and we'll start directly, okay? Okay, miss. So let's start. First of all, I'm just going to talk a little bit about what we have explained the last week, which was the writing. We have explained the personal narrative essay, how to write a narrative essay, and the parts of a narrative essay. Let me just talk a little bit about the worksheet that you have for this week. The worksheet that is on the application for this week is a graded worksheet. I'm telling you from now, so it's obligatory. You have to do it, and Anna, I'm gonna take a grade. So you have from now till Friday to do it and send it to me on WhatsApp because I want to correct it and take a grade. So this is going to be a graded homework or a graded worksheet. I just want to add a grade on the worksheet to make sure that all of you are doing the worksheet. So the worksheet is a writing So the worksheet is a writing worksheet, and I want to make sure that you are all doing it. So that's why that's why it's going to be a graded worksheet. This is the first thing you have to do this week. You have to do the worksheet, and you have time till Friday. Okay? Is everything clear? I will allow you to unmute yourselves in case you have any question. Yes, Adam?
Miss joined.
Yes, miss.
Miss, what were you saying, miss? We have to solve a worksheet?
Yes, you have to solve the worksheet and you have to do it. You have to do the worksheet and send it to me on WhatsApp. It's graded, okay?
Okay.
Okay. Okay, miss, but صوتك طلع ما بقطش. The sound is lagging.
Yeah, because of the connection, it's very windy.
Yes.
Okay. So, the first thing that we have talked about is the worksheet. So, as I said, the worksheet is graded. I want it by Friday. You have to do it. Take a picture, send it to me on WhatsApp. Deal? Is everything okay clear concerning the worksheet?
Miss, maybe the 3 days, the coming, I'll do it.
Akid, you have to do it. It's graded. Okay. Time. Now, let's move to something very important. Before we start with the reading lesson and so on, of course, we are going to start with the comprehension skill. Okay? The comprehension skill here is one of the most important skills that you have to. Which is the figurative language and the literal language. First of all, let us explain the difference between literal and figurative. When I say that this is a literal language, I mean that this language means exactly what the word functions, or the word functions exactly as it is defined. Yeah, and for example, if I said the car is blue, this means that the car is really blue. It is literally blue. Okay? If I said he caught the ball, this means that he literally caught the ball. He really caught the ball. And I mean it, yani it's something real. I'm not using it just to show something else. I'm using it to literally show that he caught the ball. Clear? Clear, miss?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Now, I move to the figurative language. The figurative language is different. How? In the figurative language, you have to figure out what the word or sentence means. You have to figure out. Let's see the examples. I've got your back. Who can explain the sentence to us?
It means the person is here to help.
It means what?
The person is here to help.
Exactly, is here to help. The person is supporting you. This person is protecting you. So did they exactly say, I am protecting you? Or they said, I've got your back?
They said, I've got your back.
I've got your back. So you have to figure out the meaning, right?
Yes.
If I said, you're a doll, do I mean that you are literally a doll, you are really a doll, or I'm just saying this to, let's say, compare you to a doll?
Compare.
To compare me to a doll, right? So you're a doll doesn't mean that you are literally a doll or you are really a doll. It means that you are like a doll. You are soft, you are pretty, you are beautiful, you are, let's say, cute like a doll, but you are not literally a doll. So I'm comparing you to a doll. Okay? Did you understand first what is the difference between literal language and figurative language?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, great. Now, we are going to move to the first kind of figurative language. Let's see. Adam Hajaji, read, please. Adam Hajaji, please read. Zainab Asirid.
Simayo, it is a direct comparison between two things.
Zainab, it's simili. Simili. This is the way we read it.
Simili. It is a direct comparison between two things essentially unlike, but resembling each other in at least one aspect. As like similar to are the tools of simile, significance. One, it's a device of art and explanation. Two, it is used to compare the unfamiliar to some familiar things. Example, the history paper was as tricky as labyrinth. At exam time, the high school student was as busy as bee.
Okay, so when I say a simile, miss, it means I am comparing. I am doing a direct comparison between two things. These two things or people or whatever that I am comparing are unalike. They are different, they are unalike, but they resemble each other in at least one thing or one aspect or one factor. And in order to compare in a simile, we always use as or like. Now, the significance is the use. Why do I use a simile? I use a simile because it's an art of explain. Can you hear me, miss?
Yes,
so it's an art of explanation. So I use it to explain to the reader, to compare to the reader, to try to show the reader the things as they are. The second use, it is used to compare the unfamiliar to some familiar things. Okay, using as or like. So I can say, he is fast like a cheetah. Like, so I'm using like, he is fast like a cheetah. So I'm comparing he, the boy, to the cheetah. I'm comparing two. Okay? They are unfamiliar. They are unalike. A cheetah to a human being. But they are similar in one aspect, which is being fast. So he is fast like a cheetah. So I'm comparing him to a cheetah using the like. Daiman in the simile, you have to use as or like. Tafa'na? Clear?
Yes.
Yes.
Great. Let's read the examples. Read the examples, Yada. Adam Hajaji, read the examples, please. Adam is not answering. Yalla, ya Adam, read the examples, please.
Example, the history paper was tricky as a
labyrinth. Yes, it was tricky as a labyrinth, okay?
Yes.
So I'm comparing the history paper to a labyrinth because it was tricky and I used as. Okay? The second example, Adam.
At exam time, the high school student was as busy as a bee.
So at exam time, the high school student was as busy as a bee. What am I comparing here? Who can tell me?
B to the student.
What? What am I comparing?
The B
to the student, the high school student to the B. Very good. I'm comparing it him to the B. They are common in one thing, which is being busy. Very good. What is the tool I use in order to compare?
As
excellent, very good. Who can give me an example from your own, yani, any simile, something very simple. Who can give me an example? Anything, Gwala? Nobody can give me an example, Ma'ul? No way.
Miss?
Yes?
Miss, can you repeat it, Miss? The question, Miss, I didn't hear.
I need an example, any example, a simile example. Who can give me a simile example?
For what?
About a simile. Into, give me a simile.
Oh.
My sister was hopping like a bunny from excitement.
My sister was what?
Hopping like a bunny from excitement.
Very good. Very good. Excellent. Okay, excellent. She is pretty like a moon. This is a simile. Okay, there are many kinds of sentences that you can use, miss. You know, do not get confused. Yes, Lamar?
She is as fast as lightning.
Excellent. She is as fast as lightning. Excellent. Very good. This is nice. Let's move, guys, to the second kind of figures of speech, which is the metaphor. Who will read? Adnan? Yes, Adnan, read.
It is an indirect comparison which immediately identifies one thing with another, etc. Between one thing and another without using any tool of comparison science fictions. It arrests That one thing is that is another thing, not just that one like another. It gives the clearness, charm, and this distinction to the style. It is
thankness.
It is a profoundly important and useful device. It doesn't only explain by making the abstract or unknown concentrated and but familiar, but it also Miss, what is this word? Also, enlivens
by touching.
Enliven?
Yes.
By touching the reader's imagination. Affirms by showing a relationship between two things seemingly to each other. Similarly to each other. She is fishing in troubled water. He drowned in a sea grief.
Okay. So the metaphor, miss, is different than a simile in one thing. In two things, actually. The first thing is that a metaphor is an indirect comparison. In the simile, it's direct. You just say he is like this, he is like that. But in the metaphor, it's different. In the metaphor, you do not compare a direct comparison. You do not make a direct comparison. You do not make a direct comparison. You make an indirect comparison. The reader should deduce the comparison that you did. Okay, but you are doing an indirect comparison. Now, do you use as or like in a metaphor?
No,
very good. So in a metaphor, we do not use as or like, okay? In a metaphor, we only use the words, yani how we are comparing, but we do not use as or like. Clear till now? Okay, let's say she is fishing in troubled water. What do I mean by troubled water?
It means there are waves in water.
Dirty water, very good. She is fishing in a troubled water. It means in a dirty water. What do I mean he drowned in a sea of grief? In a bad way, maybe, let's say. Or he is walking in a dark path, in a bad path. Okay? So this is what do we mean by a drowned in a sea of grief. Okay? So I'm trying here to compare, but an indirect comparison. Yani without showing what am I comparing to this thing or that thing. Type. If I said, he is a lion, what do I mean by that?
He is strong
like a lion. So without using like, I'm saying he is a lion. So I'm doing an indirect comparison without using as or like. Okay? Clear? Okay.
Yes.
So this is what do we mean by a metaphor. So as we said, a metaphor, a simile is a direct comparison between two things or which are unlike, but they resemble each other in one aspect or one thing at least. The second thing is the metaphor. The metaphor is an indirect comparison, which compares indirectly and without using a tool, without using as or like. Okay, let's now move to the last kind. The last kind is the personification. The personification is something is something different than the simile and the metaphor. The personification is, as you can see, Aslan, the word personification, yani person, yani I'm taking a certain character or a feeling or a behavior or a certain action from a person, yani from a human. I'm borrowing this characteristic or this action and I'm giving it to an animal or a thing. How? Yani, I use this action, which human beings do it, and I then give this action or this feeling or this characteristic to an animal or a thing. Okay? Let's see, why do we use a personification? The first thing is that it functions as a device of art. Yani, it makes your reading or your paragraph a piece of art. It can often serve to make an abstraction clearer and more real to the reader. Ideas can be brought to life by personification, and objects can be given greater interest. So you can, let's say, imagine or try to know exactly what the writer is trying to tell you when he uses personification. When I say the sky weeps, who can tell me what do we mean by the word weeps? What do we mean by weeps? Does anybody know? You don't know what you mean by weep? It means cry. Okay? Miss, can you hear me? Hello? Guys? Guys? Okay, Karam.
Yes, ma'am.
So please leave the meeting and join again.
Okay.
Okay, so let's move to the personification. As we said, the personification is to use a certain human characteristic and give it to an animal or a thing. If I said the sky weeps, what do I mean by the word weep? Who can tell me what do I mean by weep? To weep is to cry. When I say weep, means cry. Who usually cries?
Sheep.
human beings, right? So I borrowed this action or this characteristic from human beings and gave it to the sky to say that it is raining. So other than saying it is raining, I can say the sky is weeping. Okay? The shadow of the moon danced on the lake. The shadow of the moon danced on the lake. Who dances?
The humans.
Human being dances. Very good. So I used this action, the action or this behavior, the behavior of dancing. I borrowed it and I gave it to the shadow of moon type. If I said the flowers are dancing, it means the flowers are moving because of the wind, maybe. But I'm using this action to show that the flowers are moving. Instead of saying the flowers are moving because of the wind, the flowers are dancing due to the wind. Okay? Clear?
Yes.
Yes.
Now I want you to move to the exercise. You have 1 minute to do it. 2 minutes. I think 2 minutes are enough. Yala, go ahead. Yes, Miss, start please with the first one. Who will do it? Yalla, quickly.
And we don't have much.
Yalla, Aya, please read number one.
Jenny had cooked the candy too long.
Yes.
When she was ready to cut it into squares, it was a rock.
Okay, quickly, please.
Metaphor.
This is a metaphor. Very good. Okay. Can you explain what? Can you explain why?
This I can explain if you want.
Yeah.
It was a rock, like it was very hard.
It was very thick. It was very hard. Very good. Number two, yalla, who will do it? Quickly, do it. Please. Lamar Safina Bin. Yalla, yalla, Lamar.
Sue Ann worked hard on her report. After she gave it before the class, she felt light as a feather.
Okay.
It's a simile.
It's a simile. She felt as a feather. Number three. Yalla ya Adnan.
Number three, this isn't the personification.
Read it, please.
The trees of the forest sympathetically watched over the lost child.
Yes.
Personification,
very good. Okay. Number four, the storm was a savage beast. It took the house in its teeth and shook it. Yalla, who will do it? Yalla, ya Aya, do it.
Simile.
This is a simile. The storm was a savage beast. It took the house in its teeth and shook it.
Personification.
The first one is a metaphor. The first part, when I said the storm was a savage beast, is a metaphor. I'm comparing the storm to a savage beast. And the second part is a personification, yes. Okay?
Yes.
Right. We will continue tomorrow and we have less than 1 minute. Thank you all.